Welcome to the Knitting Samurai Plus One video podcast. I'm your host, Steph, also known as the Knitting Samurai, and this is episode 55. In that in-between place. We'll get there. So, it is the last week in May. It is actually, if we want to be precise, May 30th. It's about 90 degrees here in New Hampshire. It's a total heat wave for us. Sort of unexpected and caught me by surprise. I mean, I knew it was coming, but I forgot what 90 degrees feels like. And so it is roasting down here. And plus, I've got all the lights on. And it's 7 o'clock at night, and the sun is setting. And Roland's in bed, and Steve's up reading upstairs. And I am ready to sit here and chat with you and then rush upstairs into the air-conditioned bedroom. For some reason, he ran the air conditioner upstairs, but not the downstairs one today. So, I don't know. I can't explain his choices. And it's a Thursday. I'm sorry, I got a drink. I didn't drink enough today, and I've had this low-grade headache just like, and had two lattes and an Excedrin to try and take care of it. And anyways, you don't want to hear about that. You know what you do want to hear about? This. So this blanket over here is The Little Star by Jacqueline Van Dillen. I knit it with Lenny and Brand Cottonese in the rose colorway. It's a 50-50 acrylic cotton blend, and I used US size 8. So there, I mean, I guess the FO is the happy ending to this story. So last week, if you're new to the show, thank you for joining us. Oh, and I do want to ask you, okay, can you just pause it right here if you're a regular listener? Come back in 2 seconds. Just take a minute and please, please, please go over and give me a star rating on Ravelry. I would really appreciate it. I have some great reviews out there and a few star ratings, but I'd like a few more to help boost Knitting Samurai Plus One closer to the top. So if you can just pause, take a minute, hit the star button, I would really appreciate it. But okay, back to this. So last week I talked about how this was a nightmare of a pattern to knit. This is from the Cascade Quick Baby Knits, Quick Baby Blankets book. Mac is joining Linus just off camera screen this side, right for me. Is it right for you? I don't know. Anyways, a bear of a project, round 31 on, and it's about a 70-80 round blanket, was incorrect. I went into a great deal of detail about this blanket last week, and I have a long show, so I need to keep it short. So, I finished it, I blocked it, I decided to, rather than doing the crochet border, which was very pretty on the pattern, I wanted to do knit, so I did a scalloped edging, which I put the instructions for on my Rav page in case anyone out there thinks it's lovely and wants to attempt it. I'm pretty sure this is a reversible blanket because even though, so that's the side that's pictured, they pictured the back of the blanket. This is the right side as you're knitting it. This is considered right side. I don't know. I don't mind either. And my little scalloped edging is sort of crazy. Foldy, rolly, whatever way it wants. But you know what? I think it's a great, delicate little blanket. I think that the little baby princess that this is for is going to be nice and toasty warm with it, and her mom is going to just love it. And I'm guessing her dad will love it more because he's very excited to have a princess. So that is an FO, and it took me like 2 weeks to knit. I used just over 500 yards. When I was going along, I wanted to make it, because the pattern is oblong, and I wanted to make it 38 inches square. I was measuring at this point on the diagonal instead of measuring out this way. So I don't know what the finished measurements are. I don't know how squares work. I think it should be fine, right? Equilateral, I don't know, whatever. It's a good size. It's definitely more than adequate for a car seat, stroller blanket. It could be lots of things, lots of potential here. So I'm very pleased with it. I used 2.5 skeins. So I have, I think, 70 something yards left. So a little more than 2.5 skeins, but yay, it's done. Want to see my other FO? I actually have a few FOs. These are finished. Oh yeah, oh yeah. So these are the goth socks by, whoops, I'll show you this side. As you can see, I have a little split. And right there, I need to weave it. So I'll show them to you like this. Goth socks by Inspiration Dye Works. It's her yarn, the colorway. So that's this beautiful red, black, and purple stripe. I just did the basic 2x2 toe up sock that I like to do. 9 grams? No. Oh, shoot. You know who you are. I believe it's Linda. We met at SSK. You dropped me a note and asked about the pattern for this. So yes, I do knit a lot of socks, and I've done it enough that I have a canned version basically based off of Wendy Johnson's toe-up sock book, one of the basic constructions. So I start with 12 stitches on each needle, increase every other row up to 64 for my standard sock. I do a 2x2 rib on the top of the foot. I keep it stuck in it on the back until it's about 2 inches shy of the length I want. Then I start doing increases every other row on the bottom side of the foot. When I get to 86 stitches, I believe is the number, all the way around, I start to work the slip stitch heel. So I work that. No, I do the heel turn. So get that extra bit, that little triangle of black right there. Yeah, you can see it a little better here. Get that red section, work that, and then do the slip stitch heel, join it back up in the round, and then knit whatever length I want for a cuff. I had been thinking that these would be great as short socks, and I still agree with myself. It was a pretty generous, so that's my basic sock construction. It was a pretty generous skein, and I think I have like 170 yards left. Not enough to knit another pair of socks for me, but I'm definitely going to have to come up with something wonderful to use it for because I do love this yarn. Oh my god, it's gorgeous. Go out and get yourself some. Inspiration Dye Works. Haven't washed them. I'm sure they'll be fine. So that's my second FO. And then, let's see if I can do this without flashing you. The third FO. Oh yeah! So here he is. In all of his dinosaur blanket glory, where's my book? I brought the book down so you could see and compare. Oh, that's the back of the book. So this is by Sandra Boynton. It's a listen, look, touch, and giggle book. It's all about the dinosaur and his blanket, which is a nanite. And, well, we call it a nanite at the house. See, those things, they just seep into your brain and you don't even realize it. Like today I was sitting in a meeting, big meeting with the VP and all that, and we're going over the budget for the next year. I should be paying attention. This is an important meeting. I could be called out to answer some questions on my business. And just outside the office room, the office windows, they're putting in a patio so that they're putting in a patio, and there was an excavator out there, and all my brain could hear was tractor, tractor, which is what Ro screams every time he sees a piece of construction equipment. Even though I know the right words and know it's an excavator, he still calls it a tractor. Also, he calls every kind of truck a truck, so he points out all the tractors and the trucks as we drive down the road. Anyway, so I should have been focusing, and all I could hear was tractor. And when I look at this, all I can think is, that's a nanite. But it's not a complaint. That's a wonderful thing to have my little boy in my head talking to me all the time. So, as you'll recall, I finished the plates on the tail. I did not sew them straight. Can you see that? I wasn't feeling so well when I was sewing these. We had, Ro and I both had a cold this past weekend. So I wasn't feeling so hot, and dinosaur is not drawn the same way every time. His scales are imperfect, his eyes are wonky, like, he's just, it's okay that he's not perfect, and right, dinosaur? Yes, okay. So I finished that. I actually I had completed one arm already. I tried to recreate the second arm. I made this monstrosity of a hand and put it aside, tried again after I knit the scales, because they're based on the, not scales, plates. The construction of the fingers is based on the construction of the plates. So after I knit a few more of the plates, I was like, oh yeah, okay, I remember how to do this. And I was able to make a second hand that looked like the first. So there he is. And I am somewhat dismayed to report that he's been sitting on the coffee table since Saturday morning. It's Thursday night. And Roland has not played with him once. We've run down his horse blanket. But yeah, he's not really interested in it. So I think he's adorable. He's definitely a labor of love. I am going to put him by the, I need to take him upstairs now that you guys have seen him, and put him next to Roland's nighttime reading chair. And so maybe we'll hug him while we read the book. And if he doesn't like him, he doesn't like him, and he'll just sit on Roland's dresser and be a decoration, because, man. So, anyways, little bit of detail on this guy. This is based on four different patterns. Monster and Dinosaur Patterns by Rebecca Danger. Yeah, I was just running through it in my head. They're all by her. Listed on my project page if you're curious to see what I used. Like, I know these are Harold the Houseplant's feet. I think this is Dot, the dress-up fox's legs. I'm not sure about that. And then this is the general body construction and head of Terrence the Tap Dancing T-Rex. And then the, oh, and the tail too. And the plates, why can I not get that word right, are from the Stegosaurus, whatever his name is, that pattern. So, I'm sorry, I don't want to try and put all my instructions together. I sort of winged it based on what I saw in those patterns, but that gives you an idea. If you want to try and knit one, that's where I'd look first. So, and he is knit with Cascade Heritage on US size 1s, 2.25 millimeter needles. So, those are the FOs, right? And I finished them Tuesday. By Tuesday, I had all that done. And that just left one project on the needles, which is not a really inspiring project. It's more of a functional process knit. It does not motivate me to knit it, which is the Christmas stocking, same exact construction as the goth sock that I talked through, and this is Patton's Croy in the, I don't know, Patton's Croy rag shades. I think it's pink rose something. No, I think it's brown rose. Rose brown? I don't know. Anyways, on 2.5 millimeter needles, just a 2x2 rep, right? I mean, it's great to have projects like this on the needles, but I can't knit vanilla boring 2x2 rib socks all the time or feel inspired to knit by them. So I had this, but then I had nothing else, and I was thinking about the Grace and the Peasy, and I know that some other people have picked up the Grace, and that made me want to knit a little more, but oh, a sweater, and it's gonna be hot, and anyways, wine, didn't want to do it. And so I started looking around and thought, well, let's go back to working on my goals, right? Why not? I could take a break from baby blanket knitting. I was all baby blanket a go-go, and now I've completed three of them. So I thought, oh, what else can I do? So I pulled out my Best of Knit Scene book. Whoa! Where are you hiding? It should be set open. For the love of Pete. I have to tell you, I started watching The Voice this past weekend. Dad and Steve were gone, and Mom and I were flying solo, and she loves The Voice, and, well, not solo, we had Romo, but we were watching The Voice, she got me into it, and that is such a good show, oh my god, so, I have to tell you, Michelle is Mom's girl, she loves Michelle, and I really liked Sarah Simmons' performance, but since that first showing, I have now sort of switched over to really liking Amber, because that Bond performance was amazing, so I haven't watched the elimination for this week, but I will. Anyways, so I pulled out my knit scene book and I decided to cast the Michaelmas mitts on by Cicely Glauck McDowell. McDowell. McDonald. And these are going to be, the minute I saw them, I knew they were perfect for her, a Christmas present for my boss. Knit in a dark brown or a dark gray or black color. She'll wear them all the time. Totally her. She accessorizes to the max. So I dug around in my stash for a while and I was looking for things to do. And still, that really wasn't inspiring me. And I still, 2 days later, I feel like I'm in that in-between place. I've just finished things, my needles are mainly clear, and there isn't anything exciting to knit. So, I have more things on the needles to show you, and I will. But I just want to show you real quick what is inspiring me that I printed out today that I'm thinking these have to be next on the needles. I know I had a list of other things, but these have to be it. So the Renfrew hat by Jane Richmond from the Island book would be an excellent choice for me. I think that hats make great quick projects, good fast FO. And then I was thinking, I haven't knit my little guy anything for a while. So what about, this has been in my queue, well, at least since fall 2010 when it was published, would be my guess. This is Seal Island by Amanda Schausger. Anyways, so that is a beautiful cable-y vest. I will call it a sweater for this and count it towards my sweater goal. And then, most of all, this amazing layering piece. I was flipping through my queue and I landed on this again, and this is the Twist Pullover by Cicely Glowick McDonald. I'm not a fan or anything. And this says originally published in Knitwear Spring 2012. I bought it off the Interweave website. I love it. It's a really awesome construction. I'm trying to see if there's another picture I can show you. There you go. That's how it looks when it's not wrapped, if you wear it flat. Which I would never wear it flat. I would totally wear it wrapped. It's sized up to a 54-inch backside. They give measurements for the back. They don't do chest, which you can sort of see why because it's up. But I have to knit this. I have to knit this with some amazing semi-solid yarn and wear it this fall. So this is inspiring me right now, so it may end up on the needles. The pattern the yarn suggested is Alicia Goes Around, Panoply of Peacocks. I have some of that. I don't think I have 3 skeins, which is what I'm going to need to knit this on 6s. So look for that very, very soon, like tomorrow. So there, I just wanted to share that to you, with you. But I did start talking about the mitts. I hope you guys don't mind me being up, down, all over the place. I pulled out some Plymouth Baby Alpaca DK weight yarn. I cast it on, knit 2 inches, realized I was doing my yarn to the back or yarn to the front. I was doing it the wrong direction. So I ripped back, started again, and put it away in the middle of a row because we were watching Game of Thrones. And apparently I was done at that moment. I was just done. So I am using US size 6s. Like I said, this is Plymouth Baby Alpaca DK, and the color is color 402. I should not be doing this because it's a little more complicated than your standard. Oh, but I will. I have enough to knit one mitt, so I'm on the search for a second skein of yarn. I did PM a couple people to see if they had it. Well, they have it listed for sale to see if they have any more. If not, I'm going to knit the cuffs with this DK weight yarn. And then when I get to the point when you start doing the hand, I'm going to switch to some Ultra Alpaca, Barocco Ultra Alpaca. That their gray color is very, very close. Has that same amount of halo. It's just a little thicker yarn. I think I can get away with it. But I don't want to do one in one and one in the other, so I'll do half of each. If that makes sense? I hope so. Okay, 2 stitches to go here. The yarn is super soft. I like it very much, so I've knit on it for about 2 hours now at this point. So, not too much to say, not too much to see. But there's the first one. It is knit flat and then seamed. Because as you may have noticed, oh, let's go look for it again. So that was just so much fun the first time. There are these gorgeous buttons running up the side. I'm thinking I could get to the top of the buttons and then switch it to in the round, because why would I not modify a pattern? Let's get real here. All right, so that's, you know, it's gray. It's not that exciting. I think I'll be more excited once I have the first one done, because then it'll be like, ooh, it's so pretty, let me do another. Baby blanket knit along. It's a go. Everyone's working on it. Before I cast on this one, I cast on another one. Here, let's put it back. It's my decoration. I can actually have a couple baby blankets. I just want to share with you some of the FOs that have been put aside that I had from knitting past. So this one is the Sprout Blanket by Hannah Bretzi. Bretz. If you're a longtime viewer, you may remember me knitting this while I was pregnant with Spud and Chloe sweater in a tail color that I told myself was unisex because you didn't know. And it's a very beautiful blanket. I loved knitting it. Really easy to read pattern. Highly recommend it. If you are looking for a baby blanket to knit for this knit along, go out and do yourself a favor and knit this. So it uses 3 skeins at 160 each. So I'll do it. 600 minus 120. It's 450 yards. Ish. Of this. Yeah, right around 450, 470, 480. There, I can do math. So I would recommend making the blanket a little larger. That was my only complaint about it when I knit it for Row, is that it's definitely a car seat stroller blanket. It's not a snuggle or swaddle size blanket. So, what does she say? The finished measurement sizing? It doesn't say on the cover, and I'm not going to dig. So then I cast on a second one because I had so much fun while I was pregnant knitting it. So I chose Barocco Vintage Chunky in color 6124, which is this great, I don't know what you call that, lemon lime color. They're just like super neon green. And I got to the border, and then I lost interest in it, which really this charted part is what was interesting about it, and it was totally potato chip and drove me on to knit just a little more. So I was just at the point to start that, and I put it aside, and I never went back to it. So I'm thinking this might be included in my blankets for the knit along, only because Amy is not finding out what she's having, and the baby's room is rainbow with like light yellow walls. Like the theme is like lots of polka dots. Anyways, so I'm thinking that could possibly go really, really well. And she's the one that knits, so she would appreciate the work of that, of reading a chart. So that's one baby blanket. The other baby blanket that is, here's the ultra alpaca I would use, is in this bag, along with a lot of other things, because I got mad and I just threw it aside. So I cast this on the same week that I started knitting this, but it was so tedious to knit that I just put it down and walked away. I don't know if I'll finish this or not, to be honest. So this is the Gorgeous Gingham by Lauren Cherensky. I don't know. Also from the Cascade book. Lauren, I don't mean to insult you. That's the best pronunciation I can do. So see this? Yeah. Gorgeous Gingham. So gingham, if you don't know, which maybe you don't, is like what you think of when you think of the red and white picnic table fabric. So it's squares of red and white alternating with pink, which is the pink is really the mix of the red and white, and that's what a gingham is. It's two colors mixed. Well, two colors with squares of mixed color in between. I'm not going to show you a picture of the blanket. You can see it if you want to. We all know what a gingham looks like. Well, the pattern calls for 128, which is their, I believe it's a bulky weight yarn. I didn't want to use that. I wanted to keep using my cottonies, Lion Brand cottonies, which I'm so in love with. And so I had to downsize the needles, and I had to change the size of the squares in the gingham themselves to get the right diameter. the right width for the baby blanket. I'm a dying with her width. And it's just, it's a mess. It's a mess. And it's going to keep being like this because I'm constantly going to have a square that's a solid and a square that's an alternating color work and then a solid all the way across. And it's just a lot of ends. And then once I'm done with these squares, then it turns to the lime green alternating with the purple and green alternating. It just, I don't know. I really like the finished result. I really like the look of it in the pattern. I think it, what technically should be an easy knit, because of all these strands hanging, is becoming very tiresome and tedious for me. So if you have any advice on how to manage these and keep them well behaving, so I have four of the lime greens to keep under control while I'm using my primary purple here, please tell me. I would really appreciate it because, this is not easy going. And I want to knit it because I really do like it. But of course, the baby that this is for is due in July. I have an alternate blanket I could give her if I don't finish this. So, and then lastly, I don't know what this is. Oh, but I have the pattern maybe. This baby blanket. I don't even know when I cast this on. Oh, week 32, it's a shower. These are show notes. From week 32, I believe week 32 means that it was while I was pregnant. Here's my chart of what it's gonna look like. This is from Knitter's Book of Wool. Oh, that's so frustrating. I will put it in the show notes. But really, all I want to show you is that here's my pattern of what I wanted to do. And the blanket is knit in stripes. And I was using mainly Cascade 220 and Dream and Color Classy. Right? This is Dream and Color, Dream and Color, Dream and Color. Cascade through here. Cascade, Dream and Color. So I guess only one Dream and Color. I mean, one cascade square. The rest are, this one might be. Anyways, so it's knit in strips, six strips that you sew together, and there's a stockinette one, a seed stitch, a stockinette, a stripe, stockinette, and then a cabled one. And I finished one and a half of these. Maybe you remember them again if you're a longtime viewer. And I just shoved it aside in this bag, and so this bag is now the bag of languishing blankets. So there, there's some good, some bad. Not every blanket works out, and if you cast on for a baby blanket and you are not into it, don't force yourself to do it. Put it in your bag of languishing baby blankets and knit one that you like, because there are a lot of good baby blanket patterns out there, like the Sprout and the Graphically Gray and the Pie Shawl that I converted to a baby blanket. So that's it for all my needles, but that's not it for the show. Don't worry. Look at this, 2 pages of notes. Oh yeah. I want to give you a 2013 update on my goals. It's April 30th. No, it's May 30th. We are 5/12 of the way through the year. And I can happily report that my 13 self-striping socks goal, I am on track. Woohoo! I have completed 5 pairs so far, 1 each month, which means I have to get an extra pair in somewhere, but I will. Because basically, that pink sock's almost done and we haven't even started June. So, I did my 716 pair, my Schools in Session pair, the red patterns corduroy pair, the stripey pair for my great-grandmother, and the goth stripe socks that you just saw. So 5 done. Go me. 13 patterns from books. I have to say I am almost a check. I'm giving myself an A- here. Maybe a B+. I have completed the pebble beanie. I knit 2 arbutus and the welted took 4. So I have 4 out of 13 there. So if I, but I've now cast on out of here, and if I knit the Renfrew, that will make me 6. So that would be perfect. The goal of knitting 1 vest, 2 baby blankets, and 3 Christmas stockings is a seesaw here. So I haven't knit a vest for my dad. Baby blankets, I've knit 3, so check, done. I don't know if you saw that. And the baby blankets are the Little Star, the Graphically Gray, and the Pie Shawl. And then 3 Christmas stockings. I haven't really thought about it. That could be an inspirational project for me to put a bunch of bits and bobs together and enjoy doing the color work, because I do like a bit of color work every once in a while. Frankly, at 90 degrees, I'm not thinking about digging around in my yarn and putting together what I want to do for Christmas stockings, but don't count that goal out yet, just because it hasn't been started. And then the vest for Dad, I know I said it already that I haven't done anything, but I think that's one that's just going to fall by the wayside. I can't imagine I'm going to do that. I could, but right now, it doesn't look good. 13 sweaters. So I've knit 2, the Dark and Stormy and the Harvest Moon. I am definitely falling behind here. I have 2 half-finished sweaters that I am not really motivated to touch right now. The Grace would be the quickest to finish if I went back to that Grace by Jane Richmond using the Stacy Tacky tweed yarn that I have, the green sweater. I could bang that one out in probably 2 weeks. So could get back on track there. And then 13 oldest yarns. Really, I've only used 1, and that was the mint green cotton yarn for the pie shawl. So when I was pulling out yarns to use for either the Renfrew or the mitts, I did pull out some of the older yarns out of my stash, which could work. So we'll see. Well, we won't see about the mitts because they're on the needles and they're not with old yarn, but maybe the Renfrew I can use something older. So that is my 2013 update for you. I love having goals. I love to measure. I love to quantify. I love to figure it out. Can't help it. It's my personality. So thank you for sticking with me as I talk about my goals. What are your goals? We don't ever talk about your goals. It's all about me, 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 me. If you've got some cool ones, I'd love to hear them. Help motivate me, you, us for next year or anything. I mean, not everybody has to set goals at the beginning of the year, right? Right. Maybe you want to set a goal right now for the rest of the year to knit some baby blankets. So for the Cal, like last time I looked, we had 4 finished projects. That's awesome. Every month you can enter a new baby blanket, a new FO, into the FO thread to be entered for a prize drawing. So the first month you get 1, second month you get 2, third month you get 3. So the drawing, I'm going to, based on the number of FOs in there on the June 1st, I will do a drawing for a pattern of the recipient's choosing. So something available and giftable on Ravelry. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do for the first prize giveaway. I've got to go stash spelunking to find something really, really cool and unique and classic for you guys that put up there for June. So keep knitting those baby blankets and post them in the thread. And the discussion is going, or there's a discussion thread over in the group. And I love seeing all the encouragement and what everybody's knitting and working on. And there's some really cool baby blankets out there. Really cool. I can't think of who knit it. The one with the heart, it's really, really cute. And there's a cabled one. That looks just so squishy and warm. And there's one really cool crochet one that, you know, she must have just been in the zone, going to town, just working it bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And so when I look at it, I just feel so much zen joy, just like calm relief. So I don't know if she felt that way when she was working on it, but that's what I feel when I look at it. So anyways, that's enough chatter for me for this month. I guess I will catch you next month in about 10 days or so. I will talk to you then. Enjoy your knitting. Until then, go to some fiber festivals. There's a lot of them. I don't know when the Fiber Frolic is up in Maine. I may show up. We'll see. I think it's this weekend. All right. Take care of yourselves. I'll talk to you soon.
Here, can you help Daddy tighten these nuts?
Kitty!
Yeah, that's a kitty. Here, push on it. Push on it. Okay, hold on.
Is this too complicated? You did the first one pretty well, right?
There you go, buddy. Pull it again. Gotta get it out towards the end so you have leverage. And really torque it.
I like the clicking sound. Have you done this to these before?
Oh, yeah. Here you go, buddy. Can you pull on it? Pull it this way. There we go. Nice and tight. Okay. Let's just check some of these.
Roland, who's on your shirt?
Can't talk, Mommy.
No, apparently not. Nice stuff. Yeah.
Right, now we put it on these and tighten those. Can you help Daddy put it on that one?
Yeah.